That's bad, but what this does tell us is this: those can be fixed. position of Carmelo Anthony where the market is closing. There aren't really a lot of options. And when you think about contenders, well, we'll get into it in a second, but when you think about contenders, the market's really not that big for him either, so it's tough. But let's get started. Alright, as we know, Daryl Morey, the GM of the Houston Rockets, recently gave Chris Paul extension, and with this extension he made $39 million last season. He'll make about $40 million this season. He'll make $41 million the season after that, and in the last season of this contract he'll make $44.2 million. A staggering amount of money for a player who will be like 37 when this contract expires. So I understand why Daryl Morey did it. If you remember, when he gave CP3 this contract, they did have Golden State on the ropes. I believe they were up in the series. And in Game 6, that's when Chris Paul tore his hamstring. So, in Daryl Morey's mind, he thought they had them. He thought he had the right formula to beat the Warriors. But with injuries and it overall being an injury-plagued season for the Rockets, it just didn't come into fruition. Sam Presti, the GM of the Thunder, is actively looking for a trade suitor or trade partner, but he's not going to rush into it. He's going to take his time. Clearly, all he wants to get back in return for Chris Paul is young players and draft picks, which I don't think he'll get into young players, but it is possible to get draft picks. Again, the problem being, it's just a monstrous contract. No one wants to pay that. It's closing, but with NBA vet and a Hall of Famer, I feel like Jimmy Butler would in a way conform to his, to what he says, and that's a problem. And it makes for a bad fit, in my opinion. I don't think the Miami situation would be ideal, but it might be his only option. Have a lot of answers that need to be, sorry, a lot of questions that need to be answered, because I think the Clippers are a very complete team as they are right now. Again, not to shamelessly plug, but I did make a video on that talking about their roster, and a lot of their players, the players that you don't really hear much about, are 3-and-D guys. So when you have 3-point shooting and quality defense, it's hard to beat. So I actually believe, like, I know, like, I'm always biased and we'll say the Lakers, but objectively, I think the Clippers are, it's hard, yeah, barring any significant injury, I give the Clippers like an 80% chance to win the NBA Finals, so that's where I'm at with that, so that's why, with that being said, I give the Lakers a better chance. I think it's, right now, it's the Clippers, the Lakers, and Houston. Honestly, that's what I think. So, with that being said, I think he just left Houston. He already has bad blood with the Clippers. So, that just leaves the Lakers. That's why I mentioned the Lakers. And plus, with the LeBron fit, it just makes sense to me. As you can see, I'm kind of working this part out in my mind as I speak, because again, that's tough because you never want to burn bridges, but that's exactly what CP3 has done. So, whew. I guess when it comes to the analysis, I'll end it there. CP3 to the Lakers. But he has to work on that personality. He has to. And one more point of order before I leave. I'll just say this. If you see on the bottom right of this thumbnail, I have a picture of Chris Paul to the Lakers. But that was back when they had Kobe and Dwight Howard. If you remember, Chris Paul was actually supposed to be traded to the Lakers at that time from New Orleans. But David Stern, the former commissioner of the NBA, actually had controlling power of the New Orleans Hornets. So he vetoed the trade because he didn't like it. And he thought that the Lakers would become too powerful. Because if you remember, the Lakers were actually very, very good. Actually winning the championship in 2010. So the addition of Chris Paul, who was still in his prime, would have made them unbeatable. That would have been the big three before there really was a true big three. So David Stern vetoed the trade. But when you think about it, that would have changed the old trajectory of Chris Paul's career. Chris Paul would have definitely won a championship with Kobe Bryant. Again, because Kobe's the alpha. There is nothing to be discussed. Kobe is the alpha, and Chris Paul will listen. It's as simple as that. And then you add someone like Dwight Howard as well. That's an unstoppable team at that time, for sure. And he would have probably earned, in my opinion, about two or three championships out of that. Okay, probably two. He would have earned two championships. I'm getting ahead of myself there. He would have earned about two championships in that run. And I feel like the stigma around Chris Paul would be washed because he'd be an NBA champion. His jersey would hang in the rafters. He's already a Hall of Famer now, but you know, there's levels to this. Carmelo Anthony's a Hall of Famer. But LeBron James is a Hall of Famer, if you see what I mean. There's just a little bit of a difference. So, it's crazy. So, when you look at what could have been in juxtaposition to what is, it's kind of a sad sight to see. But that's just how it goes sometimes. So, you just gotta pick yourself up and work with what you got. So, the best situation for him would be the Lakers. More realistically, if he doesn't get the buyout, he's probably going to Miami. He won't win championships, and he'll just end on a okay note. It's sad to see for one of the greatest players in this league, but again, I really do believe he kind of created the situation for himself. He made the bed, and now he has to sleep in it. And again, this isn't a hating video. This is just straight up giving facts from other NBA players about this guy's ego and how he interacts with players on the court and outside of the court. And again, that James Harden story I mentioned is kind of that's what really sealed the deal for me. That, wow, this guy is kind of bad news in that regard. So again, yeah, not a hating video. Just giving fact, honesty, and where I think he'll end up in, how I think he's viewed, and how I think that ultimately bit him up in the end. So again,